This week we'll be using PowerLab to do a series of electromyography experiments. And as with always with PowerLab, we are going to look for things in the same place. So we're going to go down to the start menu and we are going to type in what we're looking for. In this case, I'm looking for EMG voluntary settings. So I'm going to type in EMG vol and that gets me there. So that was simple and quick. And when I click this, this actually is going to start the lab chart software. If we are connected to the power lab and everything is hooked up to the power and to the computer, then we're going to see a nice green play button. I have not hooked that up yet. I'm going to show you the components that you're going to use this week. So when I click on this, what's going to happen is I'll basically get the software opening and it's giving me a notification. And this is just because we're using new software and some of the legacy computed inputs are no longer supported with the file and the software that we're using. So it's not going to impact us, nothing to be worried about. Just click OK there. And now we can see that my start button is not lit up, means that my power lab is not connected or it's disabled. And I'm just going to maximize the screen so I can have the nice big screen to look at here. And with this, I can see that I have two raw inputs at the bottom, the biceps, the triceps, and then up here two computed inputs. So I will discuss how to set these up. I'm going to shoot a brief video of the components and we'll put this all together for you so you have a resource for this week in lab. This week we're doing a few different electromyography experiments, and we will have expected you to have read through these instructions before lab in the student protocol for lab. So there is a background on EMG. Then we go over the required equipment. So we will be using a computer system, the lab chart software, a power lab system, then a 5-lead shielded bioamp cable, that's this, and it has two different channels, channel 1 and channel 2, and an earth or grounding lead. And then we have these snap connect shielded wires, so those will go with that as well. We have disposable electrodes. We will throw these out at the end of each use. Then we have this stimulus bar electrode. So this is going to be used for one of the experiments later on in lab. We have some electrode gel or electrode paste. So this is going to help us with our conduction of the electrical signal from our skin to the electrode. Then we have this abrasive gel, and this is going to have a little bit of grit to it, so that's going to help you to abrade the skin, again helping the conduction across your skin to the electrode, and some alcohol swabs for cleaning the skin as well. We will also use a dry earth strap, which allows us to ground the signal to your body, so that's our ground for this experiment. And then the instructions say 4 books, but we're actually going to use 1 kilogram weight. So there's 4 or 5 1-kilogram weights in each of the labs set up for this week. I am going to get the power lab system set up, and then I will be right back, and we'll show you how to get the recording of the data started. Okay, so here's the setup for today. On the front, I have a shielded 5-lead cable. Right here, and this is actually labeled as far as what should be connected, so it's color-coded. And then on the back side we have the USB hooked up, which is going to go over to the computer, and we have the power cable, which is going right to the back. Just a quick time-saving tip and also saving your subject some discomfort, we can hook these electrodes up while they're on the backing right on the table. Sometimes they're a little bit hard to push on, and it's better to push onto a hard table than your subject. So for the first exercise, we will have followed the instructions to connect your subject, connecting the electrodes to the biceps brachii and the triceps brachii in the arm. And you'll also have attached the dry earth strap to the wrist. So I have this just around my wrist like that. And what I'm going to do again is just type in voluntary settings in the search bar here. So EMG voluntary, and there I get voluntary settings pops up. I'm just going to click on that. Now that I have my subject hooked up, I am going to just click OK here. Okay, so for the first exercise, I'm just going to walk you through this part. And here what we're doing is we're looking at the components that we're hooking up to the subject. So we have the disposable ECG electrodes, the dry earth strap, and just make sure you're bringing the right channel to the right muscle and having a positive and a negative on each of the muscles instead of confusing them. That'll give you an odd signal that won't be worth anything. So as I follow down here, I get a little bit more specifics about the way that I'm hooking these things up. And I want to open the software at this point. So I'm going to type in voluntary settings, EMG voluntary settings. And their lab chart software is opening up. And I click OK. And there we go. I have a nice green arrow because I've hooked up the system at this point. So now I am going to just, let's see what's happening. You know, we've hooked the subject up and we'll see how it's working. So basically what's showing up here is a biceps and triceps EMG trace. And what I'm doing is just moving my arm around a little bit, contracting my bicep, contracting my tricep. Now, we don't see anything for the integrated triceps and integrated biceps trace. So what we're going to do is, and I always like to leave this running, there's no reason to stop it. This way you can kind of see what changes you're making. So right here, I am just going to, well, I realize this input's not on, so first thing I'll do is turn that input on, and I might as well do both things for both. Put input on over here. Then at that point, I want to go back down, and what you'll do is you'll look at your EMG appendix, which is loaded onto Blackboard. So this is the EMG appendix, and what this has actually is settings for us to follow. And we are going to follow these settings for the integral right there for channel 1 for integrated biceps and channel 2 for integrated triceps. So just take a quick note of what we're doing. You're wanting to know which the raw inputs are. And you're also going to want to know what kind of an integral you're going to choose. We're going to choose an absolute value. And we're going to set the time constant also. So I'm just going to minimize this and come back over here. Drop down menu again into the integral. A couple different things here. First of all, the source channel. We are setting up the triceps right now, so we want the raw triceps channel. I'm going to click right here, absolute value. And then time constant decay, and I'm going to put in 0.2 seconds. And the other thing I should make sure of is that this auto scale is checked here. So now I've put that in. Now we can see it's getting some kind of a feed, and I'll contract my triceps off the screen. And now I'm going to set up the biceps. So the input, we turn it on. We're just going to go through those steps again. So basically, we want to take the raw bicep signal right here. We are going to choose absolute value. We are then going to choose time constant decay and put in 0.2 seconds. Click OK. Auto scale was checked as well. And now I see biceps activity. Okay, after we've set up channel 1 for integrated biceps and channel 2 for integrated triceps, we need to get the settings in the biceps and triceps raw channel to match what we see over on this screen here. So this again is in your EMG appendix, and over here you are going to click on, in this case, bioamp, and these settings should be set up correctly. So let's just take a look at the settings here. 2 millivolts is good. The high pass is 10 hertz and the low pass is 200 hertz. So I'm going to click OK, and I'm going to get my tricep settings up too. So here we have our bioamp open again, and we are going to check. We're at 2 millivolts. The high pass is set at 10 hertz, and the low pass is set at 200 hertz. So once I'm set with that, I close that up. And now what we'll see is we'll see activity staying on the screen for what we've decided we wanted set up there. So basically, you can look at muscle activity on either side and have a representation in your integrated chart up above. So that's the setup for this week's lab, the first experiment. Just follow along with the instructions for the other experiments for today. Your instructor might have a variety of different experiments that you're going to do in lab, and the settings for these experiments are just going to be right down here. So once you've opened the settings files, you're needing to basically set up what these inputs are going to behave like. So that's a big part of getting today to work out well, and have a fun time in lab this week.